So, like we said on the Yellow Couches, we are joined by a professor from UCT, and she is here to explain to us and tell us more about the water saving app. Thank you so much for coming, Professor.
Thank you.
So, as I believe, it's not only you, it's also the students from UCT who developed this app. Tell us about it.
Yes. So, we are a team at UCT, and as you know, UCT students are very innovative.
Yeah.
So, we spend some time to think about water challenges, and most of our work started with actually thinking how we can help people to track their water use. So that was some time ago, a couple of years ago, and we developed an app for mainly the informal sector, like Makaza, places like that around Cape Town, to help them to just track how much water they were using. And because everybody has a cell phone, we did a mobile app, and now the trial came, and so we changed it a little bit so that people can actually start using it to track how much water they use every day.
Okay. Wow. So by using this app, you can actually track on how much water I'm using, and amazing.
Okay, well, personally, I just want to know, like, what was the motivation behind the creation of this app?
So, I work in the information systems department, so I love mobile phones, I love apps, and so do all my students. So, we together do a lot of developments like that. Mm-hmm. We've done some work in HIV, so there's a lot of actually mobile apps that are out there that are being used to manage diseases, health services. You might have seen some of them where the city says, if you have a problem, send us a message, and so on. But we're really trying to get people to understand more how they use water. So it's not only about telling you how to track water, but also getting a clearer idea of, for example, is the bill that the city sends me, is that actually correct? Is that bill right?
Yeah.
So the app, for example, allows you to enter the data that you have on your bill and check, is the bill, am I paying what I should be paying?
Amazing.
So it's really just to get that. And perhaps also quite interesting, 55% of water in Cape Town is used by households, and only 5% of water is used in the informal settlements. The majority of people actually think that water is used in all informal settlements. And yes, and everybody shouts and screams, and the water is running on a tap. And but it's actually only 5% of our water is used in informal settlements, and 55% is used in households, and 10% in flats. So you kind of think, you know, the people we really need to target is the people that live in a house.
Households.
I was going to ask as well, like, are we being ignorant or whatever? Like, are we being ignorant towards the water saving?
Maybe. Yeah, so it's the household.
Exactly, yeah.
It's actually the houses that we need to get to. So they need to use this app. And what you need to do is you need to walk to your water meter. And very interesting, a lot of people don't know where their water meter is. So they don't actually know, how does the city know how much water I use?
Okay.
Yeah.
And there's a water meter outside your house. So the app helps you to find your water meter.
Isn't it usually in front at the front garden?
Yes, it's outside your property. You will do that, you see? So if you don't know, you ask her, see?
She knows. Right.
So you have to find your water meter, and the app helps you to walk to the water meter, find it, and then when you open the water meter, it has usually like a plastic lid or a metal lid, and then you will see that it's really difficult to read because these water meters are ancient. So to actually understand how to read it, the app shows you how do you actually read this, how do you find out which numbers are the right numbers to type into the app, and then you type it in, and then you start doing that every evening, and then you will see, I use 350. So normally what we should be using was four people in a house. You should be using around, around 350 liters at the moment.
Okay.
That would be what you use. And then you would, you know, then you get your end of the month bill.
That's really clever.
Exactly.
I think my aunt should use it because she's always complaining. How do these people know how much water I'm
using? So you tell your aunt that she must use the app. So you just download it from Google Play Store or from the iStore. And it's called Drop Drop. It's free.
Okay.
And the good thing is also once you downloaded it, it doesn't cost you any data.
Okay.
So you just download it, and then it doesn't, like normally most apps, you know, you have to have a data package. And so we designed this that people wouldn't have that because most of us want to use our data packages to download music, not to actually measure your water meter.
Going to the app, it's an amazing app. How did you guys really know, how did you test it to make sure it actually works?
So we tested it in different environments. So we went, for example, as I said, originally we went to people in Makaza, got them to test it, and they, for example, would figure out the water was being used whilst they were at work, and they realized that somebody else was actually using that water. So it was actually really cool from that point of view. So we tested it with people, and then we tested it with people in the city. So we basically got people that had a household to come and join us. And they tested it and gave us feedback and told us what they thought. So we changed the design, made it look a little bit cooler, fresher, and yeah. So, and it's an ongoing project, so it doesn't.
I think I should get it for my grandmother.
It's an F for clever.
I think I should
get it.
So apart from the initiative of like saving water, what else can people expect from the app itself?
So you can find your water meter, which is a good thing.
Okay, cool.
You can check the bill. You can identify a leak, and I mean, I can show you if you want to. But
please, and I can see you actually have it. Show us, please.
Yes. Basically, what you do is it will, as I said, it shows you here how to enter it, and you can see your readings. So you enter your readings on the. Let me just show you. So, and then it will help you, for example, to detect a leak. So it will walk you through a process on how to detect the leak. You basically do a couple of things. You follow the steps, and then you take a picture of your water meter. You leave it for 2 hours, and you take a picture again. It will literally show you where you have a leak on your property. And that's actually quite important, because a lot of us have leaks. Say, for example, a tap outside in the garden is leaking, and you're completely unaware of it because you're never in the garden.
Mm-hmm.
So it's these kind of things. And it basically presents a little graph to show you what your average water usage is. It explains to you how much water you used on the day, that you will use about, for example, it will calculate for you that you will use, say, 18,000 liters, what will the bill will be. So what you can expect.
Whoa.
It also gives you quite, I think, which is quite nice, it gives you some methods to save water. So it says, for example, if you use rainwater for your toilet, so if you collect rainwater now when it rains, and then you use that water to flush the toilet, rather than using the cistern, rather than using the button, you save an average 38 liters. So then you press that, and it will basically pre-calculate for you how much your water will change and how much less you will pay. So you will save 34 rand. If you, for example, instead of using the flushing of the toilet, you use some rainwater.
Wow.
So does it also give you tips on actually how to even use like the water you let's say your bathing water or whatever?
Yes, exactly. You can, and this is all students. Can you see how smart people
are?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Would you also recommend that we use tank or like those tanks, those big tanks for? So
a lot of people have started using that, and it also talks to you a little bit what would be called rain water harvesting. So you basically take the water that you get from the rain and you store it. I think the challenge there is always when you store it, it's the same as when you keep your bath water.
Yeah.
You can't keep it for very long because it starts smelling and there's a whole lot of cockroaches growing in there.
Yeah.
So you need to be quite careful in how the water is being treated.
But you can also use it for your garden.
For the garden.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
Professor, thank you so much.
John,
I've learned a lot. I'm going to get this app just for my grandmother.
Told you it's for clever people.
They're going to use it.
It's for very clever people.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you so much.
That was Professor from UCT on from Saving Water. Please, guys, make sure you get the app. When we come back, we got so much more for you right here next day. Don't go anywhere.